Media recognition from Bloomberg, Reuters, recycling trade publications. Patented process for 100% recovery of critical metals, including cobalt, lithium, nickel, manganese, aluminum. American Manganese is focused on recycling lithium-ion batteries for electric vehicles. American Manganese trades on the TSX Venture, AMY, the U.S., AMYZF, and Frankfurt 2AM. For more information, visit AmericanManganeseInc.com or phone me, Larry Ray, at 778-574-4444.
You're listening to HowStreet.com Radio, available online at TalkDigitalNetwork.com. Welcome to HowStreet.com Radio, the online source for market opinions. Here is Jim Goddard.
My guest is Mark Leibovit, editor and publisher of the Leibovit VR newsletters, also known as VRTrader.com. He was the number one U.S. stock market timer in the January 2020 edition of Timer Digest. He's speaking to us from Arizona. Welcome back to the show, Mark.
Glad to be here.
Thanks, Mark, Jim. Do you still have your special offer for our listeners?
We do at VRTrader.com. That's VRTrader, Victor Robert, VRTrader.com. And there's a whole bunch of newsletters you can subscribe to. You'll see them on the homepage and any subscription that you punch, and you get to the promo code section on the order form. You can enter to get a 50% off value, and then the code is 2020 half off, 2020 HALFOFF. It applies for any time frame, whether you order for 1 month or 1 year. So if you're obviously looking to get the letter, it might pay to take the 50% for the year versus just getting it one shot on a monthly. But thank you for mentioning it.
Mark, for new listeners, what does VR Trader mean?
VR comes from the volume reversal, which is my trademark technical indicator that I've had for, it's got to be 40 years. It's a technical tool. It displays positive and negative volume patterns in the market, and is the generally for me a trading trigger, but it is also applicable on weekly and monthly time frames. I know some clients use it even intraday and on 5 minute charts. So what it depicts is a switch from buyers to sellers or from sellers to buyers. And for those who actually want to get the indicator and see it themselves and use it the way I do, there's only two places you can go, two other websites, Metastock and TradeStation. These are two stock market platforms, and subscribe to those platforms, and then when you get your charts up, if you want to add, you can add a whole bunch of indicators, but mine, you can add the volume reversal. There's a monthly fee for that. And you can see what I'm seeing and, see the volume shifts and hopefully make some great short-term and near-term trades based on that volume shift. Over the years, some incredible reversals have been acknowledged with that indicator, usually at a time when it's least expected. And what I'm bragging a little bit, but I see the VR in many instances ahead of other technical indicators because you're not waiting for moving averages to be broken or stochastics to necessarily turn up or down or momentum indicators necessarily to turn up and down. You're seeing an immediate shift from buyers to sellers or sellers to buyers, and it usually occurs at extremes on the chart. So it becomes a great trading and investment tool. It's one that I sort of developed and implemented when I was a floor trader on the Chicago Board Options Exchange many years ago when I started to see large blocks of trades across the tape, usually near highs and usually near lows, indicating that somebody was coming in there and they're changing direction of that particular security. So very powerful tool, and obviously I'm prejudiced, but it's the main thing that I utilize in my stock picks.
What's your system telling you about what's happening with the stock markets right now?
Well, it's a bit negative. We're getting some negative volume here off recent highs. I try to put that together with all my other cyclical tools as well. But we did generate a negative volume reversal in the Triple Q and in the S&P. And it looks like a little bit of a trading top has come in here. So my forecast model, indicates that December could be negative for all a part of the month. I know that flies in the face of the Santa Claus rally, so we'll have to deal with that. And of course we got, the U.S. Thanksgiving coming up here shortly, and there is a seasonal tendency for a rally within a day of or a day following the Thanksgiving holiday. Outside of that, my model is down. Most stocks, many stocks, you know, topped out back in September when our model initially turned south. So I'm not making any long-term bearish or bullish comments here. I don't know what 2021 is going to hold for us. My gut feeling is I'm not that optimistic, but money has to find a home somewhere, and we found that no matter who's in the White House, stocks can go up or down. And my prejudice is that Trump succeeds in overcoming the current obstacles with the fraudulent voting out there, apparently, that that's been identified. Whether that happens or not, we'll trade the market accordingly, and we'll see what unfolds. And even in that environment, there's going to be sectors, as we've discussed in the past, that would do well under different administrations. But money's got to go somewhere. I mean, a lot of it's going into real estate recently, but being a big surge in the U.S., I'm not sure if it's the same in Canada or not, but low interest rates are stimulating that. So there's other places for money, too, but big institutions, who are in the equity sphere generally prefer stocks. And so chances are we're still going to see, a lot of action to the upside during the course of the year, but we'll do our best to fine-tune that. But to answer your question, I'm a little bearish here until the end of the year.
We'll have more with Mark Leibovit right after this.
Avon Resources Limited is a gold exploration company with significant projects in British Columbia and the Yukon. Trading on the TSX Venture Exchange, symbol ABN, and the OTCQB, symbol ABNAF. Surrounded by world-class gold deposits and mines, Avon's 23,000 hectares Forest Kerr Gold Project is located in the heart of the Golden Triangle in northwestern BC. For more information, visit us at avonresources.com.
Engineer Gold Mines is focused on the exploration and development of the historic high-grade Engineer Gold Mine situated 32 kilometers southwest of Atlin, British Columbia. Engineer Gold Mines is fully permitted for surface and underground exploration with the drill program now underway. Engineer Gold Mines Limited trades on the TSX Venture Exchange, symbol EAU. For more information, please visit us at engineergoldmines.com.
Welcome back. We're speaking with Mark Leibovit. Mark, earlier in the week, one of my correspondents told me that Canadians have put a record $53 billion away into savings. Is the same kind of phenomena happening in the U.S.?
Well, I have no way of gauging that. I don't have the data in front of me, Jim, but a lot of individuals have lost income because of the COVID nightmare. A lot of people are just, living from hand to mouth, I suppose, if they lost their jobs. And there's a lot of people who are still in that situation. So, I don't know. I can't really answer that question, whether they're all moving in towards savings. I'm not sure if it's all there. Of course, for the wealthy, it makes no difference, but there's a vast group. I see it even in my own subscriber base. Many clients are saying they lost their jobs and they may have difficulty subscribing or renewing. So how much saving is going on out there is a tough question for me.
With the move to real estate because of the ultra low interest rates, are hard assets like that something good to be in? Or again, it's like any other real estate, location, location, location?
Well, there's been a migration out of the cities. We know that. I see this, both here and, and I get reports from other parts of the country. The big cities, a lot of migration. I read some statistic just the other day. I don't know if you had sent it to me or I saw it elsewhere. Just New York City alone lost, 300,000, or New York State or both lost 300,000 residents here in the most recent period that was measured. And, a lot of people leaving California. I know coming into Arizona where I reside. A lot of crazies out there, high taxes, fires, earthquakes, floods, but it's primarily an economic, decision. So, the tax benefits are better here than there and in New York. And then the COVID, nightmare with the clampdown in the big cities and in California and New York and Chicago versus places like Arizona, which do not do that. I know up in British Columbia you have that. I think Alberta is a little more lenient, but the bottom line is a lot of migration into this, away from the big cities. And then even here in Arizona, you see people moving into the smaller towns away from the bigger towns. So I had a good friend who lived just north of Phoenix up in Flagstaff, which is a beautiful area. I used to have a place in Sedona up there in the mountains as well, but he told me he just relocated to Asheville, North Carolina, and I asked him why. He said, well, first he had some relatives there, but secondly, it's a very similar town to a Flagstaff, small community out of the big cities in a clean environment. So that's pushing prices up, and a lot of people are making that investment, whether it's for a permanent move or a second home, and they are certainly taking advantage of those lower interest rates. But I got to tell you, just here in Arizona, things are booming. I guess it's because of the California and the New York type migration, people coming to the sun, and I assume they're doing that in Florida as well, you know, getting into the sun, but also getting out of a crazy environment that has both high taxes and restrictive covenants regarding the COVID.
We'll have more with Mark Leibovit right after this.
Value from success, growth, and discovery. Golden Arrow Resources is a well-funded gold-copper exploration company with proven management and prospective properties in Chile, Argentina, and Paraguay. Golden Arrow trades on the Toronto Venture Exchange, symbol GRG, on Frankfurt, symbol G6A, and the OTCQB, symbol GARWF. For more information, visit us at goldenarrowresources.com or call Sean at 778-686-0135.
Don't miss out. Stay informed. Receive the HowStreet.com weekly recap with thought-provoking podcasts, radio, and articles delivered to your inbox. Sign up for the HowStreet.com weekly recap on our homepage at HowStreet.com.
Welcome back. We're speaking with Mark Leibovit. Mark, are there sectors that you would consider safe no matter who eventually occupies the White House?
Absolutely. There's plenty of areas. Of course, you know, when the market takes a nosedive like it did this past March, we saw the baby thrown out with the bathwater. I mean, everything came down. It was liquidation across the board. So barring, you know, that type of event, some external, you know, black swan type event where everybody has to liquidate for whatever reason, their positions, margin calls, or just they're panicking, everything tends to go down. We saw gold come down, you know, so there's no such thing as something perfectly safe in the markets. And we know there's no putting your money into bonds or you know, CDs. You're not getting very much interest return. But if I had to pick some sectors, we've talked about it, you know, there's a big push toward, you know, green energy, and we're seeing that. We're seeing, you know, a lot of the solar stocks, for example, energy type related companies, bunch of names that are out there like Fuel Cell or Plug Power, and we're seeing Nikola Motors, which has got that alternate truck engine that General Motors just invested in, and so, you know, a lot of interest in the alternate energy. I think that's going to continue. That's been a big favorite of mine for decades anyway, but the street has caught on, so you know, the socially responsible investing and that type of thing is driving money there. And we're continuing to see, you know, strength in the infrastructure area. I've talked about this for many, many weeks. We saw that prior to Trump's initial election in 2016. We're seeing it again. Names like Martin Marietta Materials and Vulcan Materials and U.S. Concrete and Freeport McMoRan, which is copper. So you're still seeing, you know, interest in those areas. Many of these stocks have already made, you know, some nice moves. I'm not saying you buy them today, but there still seems to be, you know, interest at infrastructure. And then thirdly, you know, we've talked about this for weeks and weeks, and they're a little extended now, but some of the small cannabis stocks, particularly the U.S.-based companies, which did the opposite of the Canadian stocks. Basically, they made money, and they knew how to manage their businesses, and, you know, did the opposite, unfortunately, that what we saw in the big names like Canopy and Aurora and Fria and Kronos and all those. Though I suppose they are trying to turn it around, but these names in the U.S. are still making money, so they're a little extended here on a pullback. They're probably still in play because they're expanding, and this is not contingent whether, you know, Democrats get in and suddenly legalize marijuana. Of course, there's a lot of hope and speculation for that, but these companies, these stocks have been moving up. They've been expanding under the state authorized ability to do that. And, you know, the legalization in the various U.S. states, and they are making acquisitions. So I suspect there's still going to be, you know, opportunity, you know, in growth in that area. I know here in Arizona, they just legalized marijuana on the vote in November, where it had not been prior to that. It was, recreational wasn't approved. Finally, it was. But that's also happening in other states. So I think the federal government recognizes the state's rights here in the U.S., that the states approve it. It's fine and legal. Of course, a federal edict would help because then they could cross the materials across state lines, and there'd be probably a bigger boom if that occurred. But that's also, you know, an area that we are monitoring and trading. And then the final thing, sort of related to that, is the commodity area related to growing vegetables or growing marijuana or growing whatever you want to grow. A lot of stocks, particularly a couple big names that we've been trading, offer clients the ability to set up their own growth, their gardens or their, some hydroponics and so forth. And there's a big growth area. There's a lot of speculation that we may see higher food prices. We're starting to see it in some of the commodity ETFs, particularly the soybeans, and the corn, for example. So, a lot of companies that provide the hydroponics and the growing materials and the gardening materials, these stocks have been doing well, and I suspect that's going to continue, particularly if obviously with the COVID, we saw this, Jim, their farmers were throwing out milk and killing chickens, and they couldn't get them to market, and, when you do stuff like that, it drives prices up, so the thought of having some shortages in food products may not be just a pure an arbitrary event that's tied to the inability to get products to market and so forth. So this continues, may continue, then people are going to have to or think of raising their own chickens or growing their own vegetables or doing their own things. And certainly these companies that provide some of those materials and equipment to do that would benefit. So that's another area that we're also focusing on. So in summary, there's no shortage of ideas out there where you might look. And there's always something new that pops up, so we'll keep an eye on it. We haven't mentioned everything that I can think of, but those are sort of the highlights.
If people are abandoning big cities with their high rises, could those abandoned high rises, both office buildings and condos, be turned into vertical farms?
Good idea. Why not? Do you know of anyone who's doing that?
I have a cousin in England who uses shipping containers to grow fish and vegetables. It's a closed system where the vegetables grow in soil that's been fertilized by the fish droppings in the tank.
Sounds like a great idea to me.
Yeah, so you just stack a couple of containers behind your grocery store or restaurant, and you have fresh fish and vegetables for your customers.
Well, this sounds like a great idea for a public company. We should explore that and distribute that idea everywhere. I'd heard years ago about a method using a fish and the kind of thing you're talking about, both raising the fish themselves and using the byproducts to grow vegetables. I can't recall the exact details, but it sort of rings a bell. But, gee, I love this stuff because being self-sufficient is great. It's also fun, and there's no greater pleasure than when you grow your own stuff. First, it tastes better, and you don't have to worry about organic and non-organic or being sprayed or not sprayed, and just the convenience of having it. In fact, personally, I'm in the process of setting up some hydroponic stuff myself just for the fun of it. And I'll, if I'm successful at it, do more and more because it's a great hobby. And, like I say, food tastes better.
Mark, can you maybe remind our listeners again about your special offer?
Sure. At VRTrader.com, if you go to the order page for any of the newsletters and you get to the promo code section, the promo code is 2020 half off. 2020 HALFOFF, and you get 50% off of any newsletter you sign up for any time frame you sign up for. Again, that's 2020 half off. Thank you.
Mark, thank you so much for being on the show.
My pleasure. Always fun. Thank you, Jim.
My guest has been Mark Leibovit, editor and publisher of the Leibovit VR newsletters, also known as VRTrader.com. If you have any questions for Mark or any of our other guests, you can send them to info@HowStreet.com. Our YouTube channel is Talk Digital Network. Find us on Twitter @HowStreet. We're also on Facebook. I'm Jim Goddard. Thank you for listening.
Comments made on HowStreet.com radio are an expression of opinion only and should not be construed in any matter whatsoever as recommendations to buy or sell any financial instrument at any time. Available online at TalkDigitalNetwork.com. HowStreet.com Radio is a production of HowStreet Media Incorporated.